Such a big place, so many streets. How you going to find?
What would we do if we got home with all those sponges?
What we do, we celebrate.
That's just what they're doing. Celebrating. Look right here first.
That was Pop Stormy Navy across the street where the courthouse deli was, and that would be Gussie and Jeff Furman and Tabby. Anybody remembers Tabby. He was the bouncer at the Monster, and he was a Key West icon. The USO was where the courthouse annex is now, and that was what a USO is: boxing matches, donuts for the soldiers. Ed Wharton's lawyer's office was over there. Manny James' office was over there. Post office wasn't there then. That was the city jail over there. People would get out of jail, they'd come right to the Green Parrot because the jailers would tell them, if you went to the Green Parrot, they'll cash your check for you and they'll buy you a beer.
$2.
Which was not true, ever. So. Proximity to Jamaica. Perfect match, really, these young military kids and the hippie kids, because they're all about the same age, they're all away from home, and they were it was kind of united by a common drug culture in a way. Generally, a very mellow bar. I mean, I can't stress that enough. But sometimes when the planets line up, it just all ramps up, and you really don't know who's in charge anymore. Heavy Duty,
one of our old customers. He was a fisherman from Long Island, relocated to Key West. And you could tell he was a fisherman because he had like two fingers on one hand and one on the other from getting his knuckles caught in winches. And I used to say that he was the only guy that used to have to use both hands to order three beers. Swamp Blues. The bass player said he used to drive down from Miami to come to the Green Parrot when he was 17 to drink because he knew he could get served. I said, man, don't tell me that shit. Eddie Kirkland, the Gypsy of the Blues. He came here to play a gig. He was 84 years old. He pulls up in a 1979 Ford station wagon with the spare tire on the roof. And I had a hotel room for him. He said, I don't need a hotel room. He stayed in the band house here. He stayed in the bunk beds. He looked like he'd arm wrestle you for the top bunk. He was like this. He's 84.
Even after all the murdering, even after all your suffering, so you know I love you so.
Is there anything else that you want to add?
Well, this could be a showstopper, but Smirk is a girl. Thank you.